Hi, I'm Jeremy Moss, and this is our last session of hashtag all the feels. Here we are at the end of Psalms and at the end of ourselves after having worked through all of these emotions for the past year. Over the past 10 months, we walked through the book of Psalms, discussing the ups and downs of life, the changing of seasons, and the biblical perspective of our emotions. Psalms has shown us the importance of vulnerability in our emotions and the beauty of exposing our heart to God. We've walked through many different seasons of life that you might have been in, and a lot of emotions that we all have to process. I hope this in-depth study of Psalms has helped you grow in how you deal with certain emotions, and I hope it's given you some ideas you can apply so you can use your emotions to glorify God instead of ruling your life. It seems appropriate that we would end this year of home group teaching by talking about praise. Through every emotion and every season, our Heavenly Father is always worthy of praise. In the middle of the valley or on the mountaintop, our God is worthy of all of our praise because He is good. We see in Psalm 150 that a great conclusion is brought to the book through this ending doxology to the Lord. It is a simple call to praise through all of life's circumstances. Hebrews 13:15 says, "Through Jesus, therefore, let us continually offer to God a sacrifice of praise, the fruit of lips that openly profess His name." Our praise is not dictated by our circumstance. Our praise is expressed in spite of those things. Hebrews even calls it a sacrifice of praise, meaning we may not always feel like it. Hebrews also indicates that it's a verbal thing that happens when we open our mouth and profess His name. The fruit of that action is praise to our God. Our praise is also no longer dictated by our location or through another earthly human. We don't have to be in a church building. We don't have to be led by a pastor or a priest. Jesus is our great high priest who made access for us to express our praise when He died on the cross and the veil was torn, giving everyone access to the presence of God. And if we, you and I, are temples of the Holy Spirit, then we carry His presence with us everywhere we go, and we get to express praise and worship everywhere we go. But what is the importance of our praise? Why do we praise? Personally, my praise comes from a place of thanks and appreciation and love towards God. It's an expression of my heart responding to God with thanks and honor because of who He is and because of all that He's done. He is Emmanuel. He is God with us. He'll never leave us or forsake us in those times of loneliness or in the times of pride even. He is our hope when we feel hopeless. He is our courage when we feel fearful. We could go on forever trying to define and list the greatness of our God, and I believe that's what we'll do for all eternity in heaven. But like the disciple John says in John 21:25, Jesus did many other things as well. If every one of them were written down, I suppose that even the whole world would not have room for the books that would be written. And that's just what Jesus did while He was here on earth. Imagine the greatness of our God seen in eternity past and eternity future. And for that, He deserves a lifetime of my praise. The fact is that when we truly understand God's character and who He is, praise becomes our natural response. Even creation understands and responds this way. The Bible says in Isaiah 55:12 that the whole earth will join in the praise of God. It says, "You will go out in joy and be led forth in peace. The mountains and hills will burst into song before you, and all the trees of the field will clap their hands." Jesus even says in Luke 19:40 that if His followers were to keep quiet, that the stones will cry out. I don't know about you, but if God intended for me to give Him praise, I want to fulfill that part of my design rather than leaving it up to a rock. So there's a reason why the psalmist says, "Let everything that has breath praise the Lord." It's what we were created to do. It doesn't say, "Let everything who has breath and finds themselves to be in good times. If our praise is fueled by an understanding of who God is, our praise will be consistent. Every season, every emotion, praise. But if our praise is fueled by our emotions, we'll praise a little here and a little there, as much as we feel like it and as good as our situations are. But as believers, praise is our natural response to what is called progressive revelation of who God is, the constant unfolding of who God is that takes place in our minds and in our hearts. It's why the angels are continually worshiping in heaven, because there's a constant progression or furthering of their understanding of the glory of God. We are people built to praise, and we know that He is deserving of it because of who He is and what He's done. So as we close out our last home group of 2021, I invite you to share with the group how this study of the book of Psalms has impacted you and how you will keep yourself in a posture of praise no matter the season of life.